Good afternoon, everyone. My name is John Stark, and I'm Clay's uncle and Jenny's uncle. Jenny and I grew up in the Midwest with a strong sense of community. So when my mother, Carol, my sister Susan, and I arrived, we were not surprised to see a lot of people at Jenny and Jeff's house. What did surprise us was the fact that so many continued to show up. Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, and here today. We brought food, we provided services such as transportation, lodging, the use of vehicles, and most of all, support for Jenny, Jeff, Ted, Allie, and the rest of the place. When you look around this room, and you see the effort that has gone into the preparation of this service, you will see the manifestation of the love that has been expressed for Clay and the Soper family. On behalf of the Soper family and the Stark family, I want to thank you all for your support of the Soper family. I have three administrative comments. First, on your chairs, you will find a pencil and a card like this one, which you are encouraged to record in your favorite memory that you have of Clay, or merely the fact that you are here. We hope that everyone in attendance will fill out these cards so that Jenny, Jeff, Ted, and Allie can further benefit from your participation in today's service. Second, all of the plants that you see around this hall and the entrance to the hall are perennials, and we encourage you at the end of the service to take one of these home and plant it so that you can remember the place. Third, as this is a celebration of Clay's life, and as we always love a good party, the Soper family is hosting a gathering at their home following the service, and you're all invited. For those of you who don't know, they live at 233 Main Street in Winchester. Now I'm going to say something for many of us. Damn it, Clay, why did you leave us? I think it might be cathartic for all of us to say this in unison. Damn it, Clay, why did you leave us? Now I'm going to run the risk of appearing to contradict myself by asking you to join me in saying, thank you, Clay, for being a part of our lives. Thank you, Clay. Clay is a product of his parents and his family. I see he is and not was, for he still lives on in all of us, as Jenny and Jeff and Ted and Allie helped him develop many wonderful qualities. His Greek heritage. Clay was so very proud of his Greek heritage that came from his father's side. He loved Greek food. He danced like a Greek. Not a geek. He looked the most Greek, like his father. And although Clay was only a quarter Greek, he was very proud of that quarter. Intelligence. Yes, he did his fair share of stupid things. But he was smart, inquisitive, and he loved to learn, and he was very intelligent. Outgoing. He inherited his mother's ability to be outgoing and meet everyone. As an example of this, I was telling Clay a story one time about when I got on an airplane and I was seated next to a gentleman who was in leg irons, handcuffs, and had a cage over his face with leather over his mouth. And I was saying how I spent the whole flight trying to pretend I was asleep. Clay said, I would have done something very differently. I would have talked to that guy the whole flight and gotten into this story. That's Clay. We all know. Athletic. His downhill skiing prowess is legendary, as you will be reminded of later in this program. Kind, thoughtful, and helpful. I had the good fortune to spend some quality time to play on two recent trips. Vail over last Christmas break, and just a little over a week ago at our family cabin in Grand Marais, Minnesota, to celebrate my mother's. My son Johnny reminded me of the fact that in Vail, what it is like to always be going forward. Please join me again in saying thank you, Clay, for being part of our lives.
Thank you, Clay, for being part of our lives.
This service is designed to be a celebration of Clay's life, so we've invited to speak representatives from his family, his volunteer community, his ski coaches, his Winchester friends, his fraternity brothers at Denver University, and his friends from Somerville. We are going to begin the celebration of life by hearing from Jenny and Jeff Soper, the proud parents of Clay, Ted,